cut your lawn, the city might just do it for you, then bill you hundreds of dollars for the job. At least that's the way it's supposed to work. But 5 on Your Side investigator Joe Paganakis found some serious problems tonight with the billing process. And Joe, people are getting bills for properties they don't even own.
Well, that's absolutely correct. While other lots like this home off of Fleet Avenue in Cleveland are allowed to have front lawns that look more like a wheat field. Lawns in Cleveland, some maintained, others far from manicured. Failing to clean up your lawn could cost you an average of $300 if the city has to come out and cut it for you. Problem is, billing by the city parks department is far from consistently accurate.
And then they come in and try to charge me $378.
David Roos says he had to fight a bogus city lawn cutting bill for his small west side lot.
I said, wait a minute, I have the nicest property on the street, and I have 8 to 10 neighbors that will sign affidavits to that.
The city later admitted it had the wrong house. Dawn Clemens owns several Cleveland homes, but she got a huge lawn cutting bill for a house she hadn't owned for more than a year.
I think I had to send them proof that we no longer owned it, which should be pretty easy for them to prove because, you know, they can look it up on the GIS system anytime they want.
But Cleveland Councilman Tony Brancatelli admits the billing system for lawn cutting enforcement is in desperate need of a cleanup.
We're not billing as frequently as we should. License and assessment, we should be churning out bills monthly. Right now, we're not doing that. And I think getting bills more often would help clean up the database.
And Brancatelli says he will call on the city's Department of Licensing and Assessment to start using tablet computers out in the field to better record when and where lawn cutting takes place in the city. He believes this will improve billing accuracy and efficiency. In the meantime, though, he suggests residents fight those bills they believe are bogus. Reporting live in Cleveland, I'm 5 on Your Side investigator Joe Paganakis.